The most important aspect of facial rejuvenation and a multi-level concept of facelift is that you can be the best surgeon in the world and do the best facelift on the worst bone structure and you'll still have a bad result. So if the bone structure is not there to support the lift, that's the base, that's your foundation. So that's one level. The second level is if the soft tissues fall due to gravitational effects, that's where the facelift comes in. They have to be lifted. That's the next level. The other level is the lack of soft tissue. So let's say you have volume loss or the subcutaneous tissue becomes very thin. Then the facelift is like putting a carpet over concrete without the padding. Number one is bone structure. Number one. So if you envision doing a facelift on somebody who used to be a model with big wide face, big wide cheekbones, and a big jaw, right? That facial bone structure, for example, whenever you do the neck, that neck on that person who has that type of bone structure may not have to be done until they're close to 60 or in their 50s. Now take somebody with a very long, narrow face, who has insufficient bone structure and the tissues are falling due to gravity, right? Without that big, wide bone structure, or let's say a recessive chin, you can do the same facelift on two different people, two different bone structures, or even do a more extensive facelift on the patient with the long, narrow face and still not have as great a result as the patient with better bone structure. So when you see a lot of movie actors and actresses on TV who might have had a facelift and somebody says, oh yeah, they look so good, I always say, well, anybody could have done that. The idea is to get a great result on a not-so-good candidate for facelift, and that's where the multi-level approach comes, because then you can identify things that you can't fix to get a really good result on a not-so-ideal candidate. So without the padding and restoration of the padding, the skin is always going to look thin. And this is particularly important on patients with very thin skin. So facelift, basically, you're going under the skin and you're lifting up. But if the subcutaneous tissue under the skin is very thin, you've got to restore it and replace it. That's level number three. So all of these factors are restoration and rejuvenation of the tissues that either got thinned out, have fell down, or revealed an insufficient bone structure to support the lifting up of the soft tissue. And of course, level four is the skin itself. So you can treat the skin in secondary procedures after the facelift. You can add a little medium type peels or a little light laser resurfacing techniques and things like that, or even fillers. Can be used for lines that otherwise surgery cannot actually treat. And that's where fillers come in and Botox comes in and things like that, really level five. So you conceptually have to think of a multi-level facelift in layers from deep to medium to middle to superficial to the skin in order to really treat all of the problems that manifest these symptoms and signs of aging.